गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन आवर प्रीवियस डिस्कशन वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. इन शॉर्ट वी हैड डन डिटेक्शन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. डिटेक्शन मीन्स प्रेजेंस ऑफ एलिमेंट्स लाइक हैलाइड्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्लोराइड, फ्लोराइड, ब्रोमाइड, नाइट्रोजन, सल्फर, फॉस्फोरस, ऑल दैट वी हैड फाउंड आउट बाय Lassaigne's reagent test. We had prepared Lassaigne's reagent. So that was qualitative testing of organic compound. Today we will discuss about quantitative testing of organic compounds, in which we will find out the quantities of these elements. In the basic concepts of chemistry, you had studied about finding out empirical formula by finding out the percentage of each of the elements and their relative number of atoms. Where from we were getting those percentage of elements? Those percentage of elements we were getting by this quantitative method of finding out the weight and percentage of the elements present in the organic compound. Now, what are the elements which should be present in any organic compound? Necessarily, if it is a pure hydrocarbon, it should be containing hydrogen and carbon only. But if it is a hydrocarbon derivative, it can contain oxygen like in alcohol, it can contain chlorine like ethyl chloride, it can contain bromine like ethyl bromide, it can contain sulfur like mercaptan or thiols or sulfates or sulfonic acids, it can contain phosphorus as phosphine derivatives of alkanes, alright. So it can contain elements like halogen, phosphorus, sulfur, nitrogen, and obviously carbon and hydrogen. We do not do any kind of testing for presence of oxygen or weight of oxygen, because after finding out the elements present in it, we do the quantitative analysis of each of these elements and we see whether total percentage is coming out to be 100 or not. If it is not 100, then rest of the percentage is of oxygen. So for oxygen, we do not require any special test. So the test which is required for finding out the weight and the percentage of the elements are for carbon, hydrogen, halogens, means fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, phosphorus as phosphates, sulfur as sulfates, and nitrogen as ammonia. This is how, or nitrogen gas, this is how we extract the elements and then we measure it by various methods. Alright, so first of all, I'll give you a mind map of all these methods. Then we will pick up one method at a time, because there are some numericals related with that. So 2-3 numericals altogether will not become easy for you to understand in one go. So I will pick up one method and relate to that one numerical at a time. Alright, so quantitative estimation of organic compounds deals with finding percentage weight of the following elements. Since these are hydrocarbons or hydrocarbon derivatives, so obviously we will find out percentage of hydrogen, percentage of carbon, percentage of halogen, it could be chloride, it could be, or chlorine atom we will take, why to take chloride, fluorine atom, bromine atom, iodine atom. Percentage of phosphorus, percentage of sulfur, and percentage of nitrogen. For each of these, there are certain methods. Like for these two, we apply a method called as combustion method. और लेविक्स मेथड। दिस विल बी आवर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन टुडे। दिस इज डन बाय कैरियस मेथड, दिस इंक्लूडिंग फॉस्फोरस एंड सल्फर। दिस ऑल वी डू बाय कैरियस मेथड। दिस विल डिस्कस टुमारो एंड we will take 2 days to discuss 2 methods for this. One is Dumas method and there is Jeldahl's method. So today our point of discussion is combustion method or Leydig's method. Say for example, if there is any hydrocarbon which has x number of carbon and y number of hydrogen, if it reacts with oxygen, then what will it form? It will form CO2 and H2O. Now as much of carbon will be there, that much of carbon will come out, and as much of hydrogen will be there, that much of hydrogen will come out, isn't it? And proportionally the oxygen will be there. Now how to find out how much of oxygen, how much of carbon dioxide and how much of water is coming out? For this we do one experiment. For this we conduct an experiment. So I am erasing this part so that I can make the experimental setup here. Experimental setup. We take a tube, it could be a porcelain tube or a glass tube. Inside that we keep a porcelain boat or a vessel in which we can keep organic compound. And some catalyst like copper oxide. From here, with the help of oxygen cylinder, we allow oxygen to enter, because without oxygen, no compound can undergo combustion. Alright. Now what happens? It produces carbon dioxide gas and water. This carbon dioxide gas and water is passed through their respective absorbers. A U-shaped tube is made now. In the first tube, these tubes are separable, they can be separated, isn't it? They can be opened, they are attached with rubber tubing so that they can be separated and they can be weighed. Alright, so in the first one here, calcium chloride is filled in. So what does calcium chloride do? Calcium chloride absorbs water. Okay, it acts as water absorber. And here we put KOH. KOH solution, it acts as a CO2 absorber. And the excess of oxygen comes out from here. Unused oxygen comes out. Okay. So we have to keep the other end open. Otherwise, there will be pressure and backflow of the gases. Alright. Now, after the reaction gets over, we can take out the initial weight and the final weight of this tube. Now, whatever the change in the weight of this will be there, change in weight will be there. That will be the weight of weight of water. And we can take initial weight and final weight of this. And whatever change in weight will be there, that will be the weight of CO2. So, experimentally we can find out the weight of H2O and CO2 evolved. So experimentally, the weight of CO2 and H2O evolved can be measured. And after that, we can do calculation to find out the percentage of carbon. For that, we will require a numerical question so that we can understand this process in a better manner. So, I will write down the numerical and then I will solve it. This numerical is from your NCERT book itself. The question says 0.2475 gram of organic compound is a question. Of organic compound gave on combustion 0.4950 gram of carbon dioxide, 0.4950 gram carbon dioxide, and 0.2025 gram of water. 0.2025 gram of water. Calculate the percentage of carbon and hydrogen in it. You have to calculate percentage of carbon and hydrogen in it. So what we will do? We will manipulate the data. Whatever data is there, we will try to use it. So this experimental setup will not be required because we have understood that this is just to do the finding of weight of CO2 and weight of water, which is given. So I can erase this so that I can get some clear space. So here we will find percentage of carbon and here we will find percentage of hydrogen. Now we know that in CO2, 44 gram CO2 contains 12 gram carbon. So 1 gram carbon dioxide will contain 12 by 44 gram carbon. So given weight is 0.4950. So 0.4950 gram CO2 will contain 12 by 44 into 0.4950. So we can calculate its weight in the given sample. It comes out to be 12 into 0.4950 divided by 44 is equal to 0.135 gram carbon. So percentage of carbon will be weight of carbon divided by sample weight into 100 will be equal to 0.135 divided by sample weight will be 0.2475 into 100. So it will be equal to 54.54%. Similarly, percentage of hydrogen can be found out. We know that in H2O, H2O contains 2 gram hydrogen. So 1 gram H2O will contain 2 by 18 gram hydrogen. So how much of water is there? This much of water is there. So 0.2025 gram H2O will contain 2 by 18 into 0.2025 gram hydrogen. So this is the weight of hydrogen which we can calculate now. Comes out to be 0.0225 gram. So percentage of hydrogen will be weight of hydrogen divided by sample weight into 100 will be equal to 0.0225 by this value 0.2475 into 100 is equal to 9.09%. So this is the way the numericals come from this chapter. Okay. But this is a reduced topic. Okay. This is a reduced portion of syllabus for 2020-21. Alright. Still, I have taught you because it will help you in your competitions further. Alright. So, I cannot skip it because the wholesomeness of the concept will be lacking if I skip it. Alright. So, I have taught you everything. Why to leave this? So, I have taught you this also. In my next class, I will tell you about Carrier's method. Carrier's method of estimation of halogens, then Carrier's method of estimation of phosphorus, then Carrier's method of estimation of sulfur, then we'll go for Carrier's, then we'll go for Dumas method, and then Gildas method. All right. Thank you.